What's up, everybody? My name is Jason, and welcome to Breaking News. EIDL approvals skyrocket as most will get paid within 30 to 60 days. It is Thursday, July the 29th, 2021. Please do me a favor, give this video a thumbs up. Hashtag EIDL with your comments below. Make sure you follow me on Twitter, where I'm tweeting at least 10 or 12 times a day. That's at TrySmallBiz, at TrySmallBiz. Username, SmallBizInc, which is absolutely positively going to launch very, very soon. Because guess what, ladies and gentlemen? This nightmare known as ILO with respect to 24 months of working capital is coming to an end. How do I know that? Based on the facts that the SBA released last night in a webinar. Shout out to writer over at Skip and Builder, who just did an excellent video on the subject. I was tweeting about this last night, and most people could care fucking less. But I'm about to tell you why they're going 12 times faster in terms of the apps they're processing on a daily basis, and almost 8 times faster in terms of the number of loans that the loan officers in the Office of Capital Access are processing every single day. So ladies and gentlemen, pull up a chair, grab a cup of coffee, ice cold beer, glass of wine. Here we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to try to keep this as simple and crystal clear as I possibly can. And I want to start off with a ballsy statement that most of you are probably not going to believe. Upwards of 80% of you that are in the queue for 24 months of working capital are going to get your money before the end of September. I know this based on the facts. The SBA finally shared the facts in terms of how many loans they're processing, how many they're reviewing, when are they going to get through the entire backlog, what does the 600,000 mean? We've gone over it with a fine-tooth comb. And what I find absolutely amazing is I talked about this last night on Twitter. In fact, I alluded days ago that they were going 10 times faster. It turns out 12 times faster. But I put it up on Twitter last night, and it went over like a lead fucking balloon. And every single comment was nothing but negative. Well, what about this? Well, what about that? Well, what about this? What about that? I gotta tell you, being in the trenches for 16 months and fighting alongside Speak and See and Builder and Steven Carlson and, of course, Ryder and Max and the team, it's frustrating when you see the same fucking people just constantly negative about every goddamn thing. So just let me fucking clarify this for you and tell you that we're about to move on to other things. Steven Carlson's going on a road trip. Kevin's running for fucking governor. Max is down in Puerto Rico doing tremendous documentaries. In other words, this is coming to an end, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, we still have the grant and the low-income policy map that we're going to work on, but this fucking madness is coming to an end. Upwards of 80% of you are going to get your money. Here's how I know this to be true. The Office of Disaster Assistance for the first 4.5 to 5 months of the 24 months of working capital processed 1,647 applications per day. What does that mean? A loan officer grabs your file. They reach out by phone or email. They say, send me this, 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 and this. From that point on, and I've got hundreds of examples in my inbox of people that I've helped, it's about a month before you get paid. So once a loan officer grabs, or what they're calling reviews, your application, it's usually a week to 10 days of back and forth. Then it's legal for 5 to 7 days. And then it's 7 to 10 days once you're approved to get the money. So once you get reviewed, it's about a month to get paid. So what we finally learned, and they've released it and it's all over the news. You can find it on SBA.gov as a result of the last webinar they did. They're doing 1,647 apps with the old outfit. We're now over in the Office of Capital Access, which again works with the major banks. They handle PPP. They've got a totally different comp plan. And as it was explained to me today, think of the Office of Disaster Assistance as customer service type reps. Think of the Office of Capital Access as business development or sales reps. They're motivated. They're much more skilled. They hustle. They've got a different commission structure that's based on performance. And we learned last night that they've gone from 1.8 applications processed per loan officer each day to 15. And you may have seen some comments over on Skip's page with Ryder. Some SBA loan officers are piping in the comments saying that they're processing up to 35 applications a day. So whether it's 15 or 35 or somewhere in the middle, here's the facts. They're grabbing or processing or reviewing 12 times as many applications every day for the last 3 weeks. The average loan officer has gone from 1.8 to now 15 or 7x plus in terms of the amount of applications they're processing and approving each and every day. So if you do the math, and here's another thing I want to clear up too. This 600,000 plus of backlog, they haven't been touched. So it is true that I and Ryder over at Skip and Builder, we have been saying somewhere around 2 million total applications for the 24 months of working capital. That number is correct because the 600,000 plus have not been touched. They're literally reaching in and pulling out 20,169 every day. And the SBA committed that they're going to get through that pile of 600,000 plus by the second or third week of August. So as I just said, if they actually get through everyone by the third week of August, and it's been taking 30 days once the loan officer grabs your file to get your money, by the end of September or the first of October, the vast majority of you are going to have the money in your account. Now, could something go wrong? Possibly. But I'm telling you right now, and I had multiple conversations today about this, these are badass motherfuckers in the Office of Capital Access. They hustle. They move. They're not these new, inexperienced contractors like we've had to read in the Dallas Morning News and other publications over the last several months. These are true professionals that work with the JP Morgans and the Bank of Americas of the world, and they're going 7 or 8 times faster in terms of the amount of applications they're approving every fucking day. So I sat down last night and I broke down the numbers, and this is my opinion now based on the facts. Around 5% have already gotten your money, myself included, almost 2 months ago. Between 5 and 7% are in approved status, waiting for your money in the next 7 to 10 days. Approximately 50% are in the backlog and they've not been touched yet. So, for all the questions that I've been getting, well, what if I applied a long time ago? You're part of the backlog. No one's gotten to you yet. You're going to get someone that's going to reach out to you by email and phone by the second or third week of August at the latest, assuming they hold this pace. And I have every reason to believe that they're going to. So if you add up the numbers, I'm told as of last night, 75,000 or thereabouts loans have been paid. And think about this for a second. Just a month ago, when the Office of Disaster Assistance was still in control, it was 30,000. So in the last 3 weeks, versus the last 5 fucking months with the prior outfit, the new outfit has processed more fucking loans, 45,000 versus 30, in less than a month. So if you just extrapolate that forward, somewhere between 700,000 or possibly 1 million loans could get processed and paid in and around the first part of October. So if I'm you, whether you're in reconsideration, which is going through a rehaul right now, there is a new customer service line that's supposed to be out by next week. No more of this, well, I can't tell you that, or you're just going to have to wait bullshit. We are being told, and Isabel Guzman alluded to this yesterday on Twitter, that they're launching a number of new customer service lines. That was also talked about in the webinar. So that when you call, let's say in the next week or two, and you say, hey, I applied 2.5 months ago, where am I? Well, you're currently number 217,000 of the backlog. We anticipate the loan officer is going to get to your file within 6 days. I assume it's going to be something along those lines. It's not going to be we have no fucking clue or no idea what we're talking about. Things are finally happening. Ladies and gentlemen, if it's me, I'm sitting down with my colleagues, my coworkers, my employees, and my family, and I'm saying, all right, we can now see the whites of the eyes. The pot of gold that's at the end of the fucking rainbow right over there. We got to suck it up for 30 to 60 days. As long as you're real and you're not full of shit, you're going to get your money before the end of September, the 1st of October. Now, what would I do in closing to get prepared? Get all your files together. PDF everything. Your driver's license front and back. Your corporate check front and back with void written on the front. PDF. Your hazard insurance. Get a copy of that PDF. I went to Buy Burke, B-I-B-E-R-K. It's an office of Berkshire Hathaway. You can get $1 million for in and around 45 or 50 bucks. The general rule is twice as much as whatever loan amount you're going to get. So if you're due to get 150,000, you can go for the minimum of 300,000. If you're one of those that's at the 500,000, go for 1 million. Then you're going to want to have your 2202, which is your liabilities form. You can get that off of SBA.gov. Just do your business credit cards or any other long-term commitments that you pay on a monthly basis. Do not include your home mortgage. Keep that number as low as possible because that's the difference between your gross revenue and your cost of goods or services or your liabilities. There's also another form, what's it called? The Board of Resolution, or I forget what it is, but it's a three-sentence thing. You'll find it on SBA.gov in the Frequently Asked Question file. That says that we had a meeting on such and such dates, and we agreed that I would take a loan of $288,000. I am the sole decision maker and CEO of this company. And I forget the third sentence, you PDF that. Again, that's on SBA.gov under the frequently asked question of what you need to get prepared for. So you get all your files together, and of course your 45060. Hopefully, in most cases, they definitely have yours by now. But if they don't, you go down to an IRS tax center, Tom, Allen, Charlie. You get a stamped copy. It generally comes back to you within a week. We are hearing, although it hasn't been made official, that the Office of Capital Access, which handles 7A and 504, I have talked to you about this relentlessly for the last few weeks. They are not nearly as strict, if at all, with the 45060. Let me say that one more time because we have a lot of people throwing shade at me constantly on Twitter in particular. The new Office of Capital Access, which took over a few weeks ago, which has done more loans in the last 3 weeks than the prior outfit did in 5 months, they are the same organization that works with the banks on 7As and 504 loans. Their rules is if the IRS doesn't provide a tax transcript, within 10 days, they're going to process the fucking loan anyway. So I'm assuming, and I can't guarantee this yet, they're going to have the same rule. Which means most of you are going to get fucking processed as soon as they grab that. So one more time, ladies and gentlemen. They are reviewing 12 times as many loans every single day than they did in the prior 4 or 5 months. They are processing between 7 and 8 times as many loans a day per loan officer approved. And based on the backlog, which again are completely untouched, there is somewhere between 1.5 and 2 million loans applications in total for 24 months of capital. And unless something comes out of the woodwork and we get hit with a major curveball, yes, 75, 80%, maybe even more of you by the end of September, 1st of October are going to have your money. And we're going to be beyond this. Now, in closing, I ain't going anywhere, of course, with respect to the low-income policy map. I'm going to keep hammering away so that we can get everybody watching me now, assuming you suffered an economic loss, upwards of $15,000 of targeted and supplemental advance. And then the $2 million caps. I called again today. Miss Isabel Guzman has already come out on record 5 or 6 weeks ago saying she was going to raise it to $2 million. Why hasn't she done so? I don't know. But it's supposed to be imminent. And then, of course, loan forgiveness, which is going to be next year. Why? The payments are not due for another year. Next year, we have an election. Mark my words. You know how Chuck Schumer comes on Twitter? Today'd be a good day for President Biden to cancel student debt. Mark my words. Somewhere around August, September, or October next year, Chuck Schumer's going to be tweeting, and I quote, "Today would be a good day for President Biden to cancel EIDL small business debt." Why would they do that? Because they want to go into the election saying that Senate Democrats, you're going to see Big Ben fucking Cardin, Jackie Rosen, and Chuck Schumer in front of a microphone, and they're going to say Senate Democrats have come together and we're going to partially or totally forgive the EIDL loan based on the COVID pandemic because you should not pay the SBA a fucking dime. Just make sure that you vote for the blue team. You watch. That's exactly what they're going to do. So until next time, ladies and gentlemen, please sleep a little better tonight. You're 30 to 60 days in the vast majority of cases of finally getting your money. I love each and every single one of you, and thank you so much for watching.